Rebel Love Show is next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Welcome to the Rebel Love Show. We're a once-a-week broadcast from Manchester, New Hampshire, where we are pro-pots, pro-gun, and pro-coffee. You can find all of our content at rebelloveshow.com. I am Ron Mathias.
And I am your Rebel Mistress.
And I'm Renee Kate, and I'm getting fat.
You're Renee Ice Cream today.
I'm Renee Ice Cream Cake.
So funny. All right, so we took last week off because of the new movers party, because we always do that. That's kind of what we normally do. But the weekend before that, we went up to Hempfest because we were pimping that out throughout the summer. We had a contest going on. We hung out with some.
That's so weird. Throughout the summer, it's like summer's over now.
Yeah.
Wait, that was already 2 weeks ago.
Was it?
I don't know. I'm still tweaking.
It's almost every a week and a half ago.
You're still tweaking.
We'll discuss that. Yeah. Hempfest was awesome. It was up in, where was it again? Rumney, New Hampshire?
Yeah. Something like that.
They changed the location last minute, but I mean, I think it was great for what it was. I don't think they'll be invited back next year.
Dude, fuck them.
Yeah,
fuck
they were
them
horrible.
And their lame city ordinances and their compliance with the police. Fuck that location.
Well, you got to give them credit that they literally got that location last minute, like 3 weeks before. I mean, they changed locations.
I wonder what was the reason, because I thought it was for more privacy, but now I'm like, I don't understand, because these people were horrible.
I heard what the reason was. I don't remember what it was.
It wasn't that. Something personal.
No, something came up.
Might be. I'm not sure exactly what reason was. But anyways, I love the festival. It was fantastic. What did you say? Top five? Top three weekends of your life? Something like that?
I'd say top two.
Top two.
Yeah. Really?
I'd say top
two. Oh, yeah. You missed day one.
It's like all these festivals are leading up to the big festival, which is Porcfest. And so it was like Hempfest was new this year, so it kind of kicked off like the beginning of all the festivals, because soon it'll be convention and everything else. And
no, maybe in libertarian time, but festival season actually starts in like May when Strange Creek happens.
Well, normal
and
people
then Zion, and then what's the other one? Great North happens.
But this one was also a freedom rally. It was like a Hempfest and a freedom rally.
Well, yeah, it was a festival that had a purpose to it.
Yeah. So I think that's why I think it kind of fell into my genre of what is like a Liberty Festival. Though there was some very statey things, but there were some very, you know, anarchist things. So,
There's a huge amount of anarchist stuff that went down there, especially with like the guy walking around selling and whatnot. I mean, that happened a lot, but
that's regular festival stuff, though. You guys haven't been to music festivals, so like you can't.
Yeah,
I have more of. I'm like grandma, grandma though. Like I can tell you,
how many festivals have you been to?
Yeah.
Oh God.
What was your best one? What is
Zion, Strange Creek, Wormtown? What was the other one I went to? I went to another one.
Which one was your favorite? Before.
Oh, Zion by far. Zion is my favorite. Zion-tific is the best. Oh my God, it's so beautiful there. It's in a rural little field in Stockbridge, Vermont, and it's so pretty. It's so nice. I've yet to see Zach Deputy there. Zach Deputy's cool as fuck. He'll be at Wormtown. I'm going to Wormtown. You guys suck if you don't go to Wormtown. I'm going to Wormtown.
Yeah, I want to go to Wormtown. Only problem is with going to Wormtown is it's really hard to get off last minute, and their tickets are way too expensive.
Wait, when is Wormtown?
No, they're not. Wormtown is so worth it.
When is Wormtown?
Wormtown is the weekend of the 18th.
Okay, well, I should definitely go because now I know I'm not going to be working. Oh, actually, yeah, I'll definitely be working that week.
Yeah, you're gonna be on call, babe.
What the fuck? No, come on, let's go.
If we don't, I love camping. I think that's the best part about these festivals is the camping. Because we set up, like, such a fucking giant. We were deep. We were, like, squad in there. Like, all those, our tent was, like, huge. We had the whole, like, the other, Bo's tent was huge. Everyone had
a had, like, a huge.
We had an empire.
We had an empire in the VIP tent. Because we were sitting with all the other artists, like, all the other musicians and stuff like that at Hempfest.
The only, like, campsite that rival ours was the one with like the tent where they like built it
on top
like,
of
on
the
top
van or
of
car.
A van.
Yeah,
and it was just, like on epic. This wooden plank, and it was just like up high over everything. It was small, but it was like it looked comfy.
That was high class.
That's all I was thinking about.
Seems dangerous though.
The camp on top of a car.
To have sex on top of the plank. I think it should. I think it would be fine as long as you know you stayed on top. So,
yeah. So let's talk about kind of like our day one magic there. First off, shout out to Rick Naya for like getting us in there so that we can talk about it, getting promoting the event. It's definitely worthy events to promote.
Oh, yeah, he did hook us up.
Yeah. First off, our tent site rocked. Well, like, how was an empire?
Well, can I say something about Rick? He's the most positive, just like he's like very lovey and happy guy. He just like prances around. Like
he was super happy, especially at that event. Like he was very
like he was very like poetic. I almost want to ask him to officiate like our ceremony. I do because I loved him. I loved being around him. I loved his vibe. It was very guru,
he definitely
man.
Had good vibes going.
So Rick Naya, if you're listening to this. If you want to officiate our unofficial love's wedding ceremony.
Stateless.
Love, I don't know, very long title. But if you want to say something beautiful about us and love and the world, I feel like that would be perfect. So I really shout out to Rick Naya. He made a great impression on me. I hadn't talked to him before.
That was my first time. I mean, I've been talking to him beforehand.
Is he a free stater?
No, he's not a free stater. He's very pork friendly, though.
Okay.
He's definitely pork friendly.
Well,
he had a bunch of pork speaking at the event. So.
Yeah, he seemed like it.
Yeah,
and plus Freedom Rally, like of course I thought he goes to Pork Fest.
Yeah, I believe I don't know if he went this year or not, but he's definitely
gone.
He
said he did go.
Did he go?
He went.
I don't know.
He hugged us and talked.
Well,
about
Well, yeah,
our
but he saw the pictures of us from Pork Fest. I don't know if he actually went to Pork Fest.
Okay.
That I don't know.
Rainbow Gathering. That was it. I went to Rainbow Gathering. that
sounds
a bit
super
ridiculous.
Gay. What was
no, it actually wasn't. Oh my god, it was just a bunch of communist hippies. Like Walmart is bad, and that was what Rainbow Gathering was.
I don't know. I heard a lot of people cheering for like Bernie Sanders.
Yeah, because there's at Hempfest.
Ugh, Bernie Sanders. Well, I mean, it's a.
Like, someone was like, no, don't vote. Like, these people, they're trying to control you. And people were like, boo, go Bernie Sanders. And they weren't being, like, sarcastic.
They just don't know.
And I was like, these fucking guys were like, what the fuck?
Yeah, hippies tend
You're
to
at
be...
a freedom festival.
Yeah, but they don't understand that. To them, it was a music festival. Hippies who go to these music festivals, they tend to lean anarchist or communist. I have seen... Usually they're like anarcho-communist, if that's even a thing. It's like weird, like they're confused. Like,
can I say something that's like really weird? I found people to be so.
Yeah, because everyone was on drugs.
Yeah, but at Hempfest, I just felt like that people were just genuinely kind. I don't know. And they just really wanted to like. Talk and sit down, and it wasn't just like a polite hi, how are you? I don't know. And then it was really weird at Porkfest. Everyone's like, oh, you're like, you do this job or you do this podcast, and everyone there is like, yeah, let's just get high together. I don't know.
It was definitely a different vibe at Hempfest. It was more hippie than Porkfest.
And
I
then
thought Porkfest
people...
was pretty damn hippie to
no,
begin with.
Yeah, but no. it's a festival, it's a convention, it's a conference, you know. So it's like you have like the whole family dynamic of stuff and, you know, all the talks and whatnot. But at Hempfest it was more, you know, you had those talks and stuff, but it was like in between music and everyone's like sitting on a field high as fuck. Or like high off something. Some people probably were just
of
high off
there.
Life.
Yeah.
And that was, I think, the best part of it. I don't know. Not that I don't enjoy Porkfest. Porkfest is still my number one. But it was just such a different festival. It's very spiritual, I think.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely agree. I mean, Hempfest being a music festival first and foremost, like you definitely had you definitely had that going on as well. But besides that, you also had with Hempfest, it was also a you know, it had a mission to like promote marijuana legalization. That was the only thing for it. You know,
more when we come back.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world?
I wasn't getting it at
Stop
all on my
using
end.
Your yeah, money. There is an alternative.
Oh, maybe
Bitcoin
if I turn
is
mine
a
up.
Stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin yeah. can be inflated or
can I hear myself now? I still can't.
I can hear you. Talk. Go ahead. Can you guys hear
Hello?
Me?
Hello? No.
Incredible Wait. Alternative available.
Hello, hello, hello.
Hello, hello, Tessa. Oh, yeah. You got me?
Now I can hear you.
You got me?
Oh, thank God.
All right.
Before you were playing it and it was echoing back in my ears and I didn't know how fast I was speaking.
Yeah,
it
yeah. sounded weird. I'm sorry. I didn't have it set up right. Yeah,
no,
for the
people in the chat room are like, who are those brain dead skanks that sound like they're on drugs? Already, its comment section is seeing over 30 million active users. Why does this keep wanting to type? Giving up so easily, wow. Why does this keep wanting to type Vladimir? Deer,
elk, I have no idea. Even moose into their layout. But teens say, all right, I need to like make a. The site's one unwritten rule. Don't okay, definitely that off. I need to. I need to like make like labels, like leave this down and up on the mixer. Oh, it is so fucking hot in here.
I was obsessed with it for a while, but now it's just boring. I'm probably gonna switch over to Happy Fast Kitchen.
Oh, sounds good to me.
When we get back, I'm gonna start smoking.
Might refer to the Yelp page for a Chinese food restaurant.
Do it now. Not right before. Oh, well, we'll put on a on the. This is the Onion News
Network. Imagine someone in your community getting in their car, turning on the radio.
So, for the listeners at home, with your own micro radio
station,
visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how you can put our programs on the air in your area. You can have lrn.fm running around.
So, we're at Hempfest. For those listening at home, I'll show you. We got this great Gandalf. This is actually number two.
We're going to talk about it on the show.
But I'm doing the break. I'm showing it on the break. We'll talk about when we come back.
Can I have what a new chair? To achieving
liberty? No.
Grab that one right there.
Sit on the
Neither
floor.
Neither does the one you have. Are joining the Free State Project, which is that one will not flip backwards.
Do you want a love seat? And they're already making
the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving
the Free State Project right, is a real movement. Just get the other fucking chair. We're still on the first few bullet points. Keene is
famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation. Jumping around a lot.
No, we haven't. We haven't talked about anything. If you're a regular reader of
FreeKeene.com, yeah, I know. You know. There's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at FreeKeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use.
We don't have to talk about ice-luge violence.
We don't have to talk about the ice-luge. I don't really care.
The three most important things you can do for LRN.FM. I mean, it's not about caring or not. It's about talking about things. You don't have to care.
Well, we'll
like, you don't have to care about them personally to tell what happened. In a detailed encounter of your events at a festival. It's my
firm belief that the AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar
among liberty-oriented groups. Support all your favorite organizations, but make sure you get $5 a month. The AMP program at amp.lrn.fm.
Yeah.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks.
Oh, it would have been over if he hit you.
Oh, yeah. Ideas, then it would have been and myself.
Yeah, we would have beat the shit out of that guy.
I would have beat the shit out of him, too, if he hit you.
You weren't there.
I would have found him.
That's why I was trying to fight him.
You would have fought him, babe.
If
have
he
you
hit
ever
you,
been in a, fought before, in a fight before?
A couple times.
Really?
Yeah. One. When?
Not really.
Tell us your story.
No.
Okay, we're going to talk about it when we come back on
I don't
want
to talk about me and fights.
Why? If they just, it's not like I'm talking about you beating people.
I was like in fifth grade. Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show, and we are talking about Hempfest, the magical journey we had there at the New Hampshire Hempfest and Freedom Rally.
Right now, we're talking about how Renee can't fit ice cubes. She's trying to fit squares into circles.
Yeah.
She's literally retarded. Okay. Back.
You would have caught that if you're watching the live feed at rebelloveshow.com. Click on live. You can watch us in studio. Hopefully the last time we're actually in the studio. Knock on wood. Because we're supposed to be gone out of here like a month ago, but yet we're still here. So a couple setbacks, but hopefully that's over.
Hopefully it's over.
We'll find out tomorrow.
We shall see.
Yeah.
No promises. But okay. So yeah. Before we left off, I don't even remember what we were talking about.
I kind of want to just talk about Hempfest. Where first off, we've been talking about what it's like at Hempfest. We're going to go into detail about our experiences there. But I mean, it was a great event, not just for the music, but the fact that they're very pro legalization and pro getting New Hampshire on the board with me being able to smoke some pot without facing being kidnapped by people in costumes with guns.
Well,
so I appreciate their efforts in doing so.
Yeah, but I felt like, there's levels. There's always levels. And some of those people were very, pro-pot. And that's what I like about it. It was a protest. So it's technically activism. You go there and you protest. But then some of those...
It was a music festival that was civil disobedience.
But I didn't really understand how people... It's hard for me to, empathize with, people who support politics that aren't just all together. Because I'm just like... How are you supporting, people like Maggie Hassan? I heard her name mentioned.
Whoa! Someone mentioned her name. I know people were mentioning how. I know I was listening to Matt Simon's talk there. Another Porcupine. He was railing.
That was the talk where people were screaming out go Bernie Sanders, and I don't know. It was weird, and I just don't understand what kind of wavelength people are on if they're still supporting those kind of mainstream. I get supporting people who want to legalize, but I don't get pretty much anything else about that.
Well, anyways, let's talk about our day one magic at Hempfest. Technically it was day two of Hempfest, but it was day one for us because we went up on the Friday. We skipped the Thursday.
Yeah, I mean it technically started on Friday.
I really think it started when we got there because we brought it.
I don't know. I was set out for this to be the most fun ever, and that it was surprising because everyone was down for the same thing. And on day one, so basically we're like, what? We got our tent set up. We got our tent site all set up, our palace. And then while we were setting up, because we're in the VIP section, the guys come over and they're like, hey, you guys are setting up. You guys are working hard.
Here's some free beer.
Yeah. We need to give you guys some beer and some water. Some beer and some water. And he's got, don't think about it. I was like, oh, I left something. He was like, oh, don't think about it that way. That thing didn't deserve to come. Don't let it fill your aura. And he was just saying stuff like that. And it was just, great. And he was just, so tweaked. And he just kept walking around in circles. But he just bringing us beer. It was just...
Helping us unpack, too.
Yeah. He helped us set up part of the tent.
Yeah.
Just the happiest guy ever. And this was the whole staff was like that, minus the people who owned the place. They were rude.
Yeah, the people that owned the location weren't that great. And I highly doubt that the Hempfest will actually be back at that location next year. But
they were horrible. But when we finally got the tent set up, and of course, Renee late came the day later.
First off, our tent is gorgeous. It's a 10-foot tent with an inflatable bed.
Our tent
tapestries.
Is better than our house.
It was hippy dippy.
We can live
awesome.
In our tent if you're down for that. We can just go to festivals.
We
gotta get
honest,
a trade though.
After this, I'm down for hitting the festival scene, going to festival to festival.
Yeah, I need
well,
a different time.
Wormtown kind of ends.
I know, I know that ends a festival racket. I get that. Next year, I'm going to Wormtown.
Unless
I somehow magically be able to get it off.
No, fuck you. Come on, let's go to Wormtown. Stop being lame. You both said you were going to Wormtown at Hempfest. I said I'm going to Wormtown.
Did you buy your ticket yet?
No, not yet. I'm waiting on the next.
How
paycheck.
Much are the tickets?
They're $110, $115.
I got a lot of expenses coming up.
Yeah, that's why.
Yeah,
I,
we
kind of
have more important things.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So basically, when we got our tent set up and we got kind of drunk because there were PBRs, but I was like, fuck it. I'll drink a PBR.
Yeah, I'll take a free cheap beer.
Yeah, why not? So we were like, okay, so the first thing we need are drugs. First thing we need. because we didn't bring anything. Like, I'm sure we're going to find something. We got already
It was literally
up.
As if we stood up. Yeah. We literally stood up.
No, first we sat down. We smoked around. We sat in, like, the round table. We were smoking, like, mapping out our plans, what we're going to do. We literally stood up, and this guy just appears like an angel. He looked like an angel. He had, like, some light green eyes, just beautiful. And he was like, want some marijuana? We were like, everyone paused because we had just stood up and said that we were going to get it.
And he came to us.
Yeah. And we looked him like in the eye and we were like, I was like, yes. Like just immediately, like we were just locked in eye contact. Just yes.
Yes.
We'll take
buy
it.
Some. Yes.
And then he was like, you know, it's hard knowing who's genuine or not. And I was like, this guy genuinely looked like he wanted to sell
us
some pot.
That was pretty good pot too, all things considered.
He was a great guy. So that was our first like wish that came true. So we had to sit back down, smoke another round.
Another round. I think it was 2 rounds.
Yeah, it was
about
2.
And then we got up and like last Pork Fest, you had your flower crown. And we're like, you know what? This is Hemp Fest. It's a hippy dippy music festival. My Rebel Mistress, she needs a
Yeah,
flower
I need to be
crown.
Queen of this festival. Yeah. So we stand up again. And we're like
maybe 15 feet.
Not even. We took like 3 steps. All of a sudden, this girl appeared.
What? She's a pork.
Oh yeah, it was Anna. Yeah. Yeah, she's a pork. And she had on her flower crown that she had made, and I was like, oh my god, I was just looking for the one. And she was like, wait, my tent's right beside yours. Let me get you one. And we're like, what? Is this place heaven? And then I think we went to go smoke again to celebrate our victory.
We had to.
Of the flower crown. And then what was next? I think we needed food. And, okay, let's talk about the vendors. Because, first of all, Juice Caboose was there. So
shout out to Juice Caboose.
Shout out to them and their fresh squeezed orange juice because that got us through our hangovers.
I'm always
the
down
next
for
the
hummus wrap at the Juice Caboose. Personally.
Oh, yeah. Their guac is great.
Oh, yeah. It's unbelievable.
Well, I don't know. Yeah. I've only had their juice, and I know it revived me.
Oh, their smoothies are too fucking die for. Yeah, that's how
I
feel.
Oh, yeah, I had one of their smoothies, too.
Every festival I go to, I walk up, and I'm like, Einar, he's the owner, and he always makes me a smoothie. I'm like, Einar, I killed my body again last night. Help me.
And then he's like, here's magic.
Then he makes me a smoothie.
Yeah, I swear, he squeezed an orange, and it was like fucking just... It's revitalizing. But so Juice Caboose was there and they had this deep fried stand which had this deep fried cheesecake.
Those are always fun.
Which was just like the best.
I waited
till
the last day
ever.
to order a whole one.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
I didn't order anything else from there. There was another place who had pancakes. Like fresh baked pancakes. Like
they had the
golden
vendors
pancakes.
Down for food at Hempfest. Like, and they're there at the main area, too.
Yeah.
But,
King's Cones?
I mean, yo, King Cone was
the
hell
they
his weren't
name?
Down. Yeah, but he wasn't down at the main area.
Yeah,
they
but he was, what is his name? Daniel, right? Daniel. Shout out to Daniel from King's Cones.
Yeah, he's a trooper. He camped outside of that thing.
Oh, yeah, he's cool as fuck.
All right, and we'll recap the more Hempfest miracles when we get back.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties.
This one guy's like a movie that chewing me out.
Okay. One in the chat?
Yeah.
Chewing you out.
And I'm just like,
it's not my fault. Guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while like, you're a female Cody O'Connor. And I'm like, okay.
You are a female Cody together. O'Connor.
Nah, Cody is.
Yeah, I'm just not, because it provides them. I used to be like that, though.
Did you?
When I was a virgin.
I was an undercover narcotics officer.
The drug becoming tainted was the best.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your
Who is Peggy Allen?
My mother.
Why did your mother send me emails?
Oh, did she send us to Seditious Sirens?
Oh.
I told her to do that.
Oh, I thought it was on mine.
Yeah, no, because I never check mine. So I told her, like, if it's important, send it to me. So she's, like, probably sending me funeral stuff.
Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Oh, poor Skittles.
It's not easy to define.
But you know when you see. It's like a lot.
No, it's not. Don't cut your beard. Cut your beard.
Don't tread on me. I just played a Snapchat.
Helping you give the finger to our monetary system of deception by providing you with silver dime trading cards.
Oh, Blake wants us to talk about my edible experience and the guy that was an asshat.
Don't worry, we're coming. No, like coming, like we're coming. But no, seriously, we're gonna talk about that later. Stay tuned. Stay tuned. We haven't even got to our VIP tour yet.
Oh, speaking of. We didn't even talk about that. Well, we didn't even talk about how...
We're still talking about our...
Oh, yeah. Anyways, hey, the guy talking right now? Oh, God, what's his name? I'm having a brain fart.
Want me to bring him back in?
This is your Robert's. Anyways, Robert's, he's awesome.
Daily want me to bring him back in? Update
in? Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's your turn.
$2 higher at $1,122 per ounce. Silver is up 20 cents at $14.75 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $245. The physical shortage of silver is increasing.
Blake should have been in that photo,
babe. But we still have plenty of Australian silver spiders.
He wasn't
to sell.
There.
I know.
That's his own fault.
I know.
9760.
That Blake check is them like out kinda, at rrbi.co. Trying to be on the download.
That's true. Yeah. I kind of get that too.
Yeah, like look at all the fun I'm having.
Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime.
It's right. Hey, she's on the air right
now. Oh my God, it's like Renee Inception. rrn.fm.
Android or Apple app.
Fuck off.
Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share Ian and the I were fighting while I was making this.
It sounds like it too.
Yeah, because I was mad. I'm just like, he's like, will you do it this way? And I'm like, lrn.fm.
You said that like in unison with yourself. Move to the
Shire. I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around
yeah.
to take
yeah.
just as seriously as I did.
Fake
I
moved bubbly to the Shire
because
angry.
I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support.
You know, this commercial, babe, should be updated with like our voices. Do this right now. We should be making it. Most of these people don't really live here anymore.
Ian won't even play our goddamn commercial.
And we need to fix our commercial.
Okay, now we know the volume problem. So we can record it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We'll fix it.
Who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here what up, are though? Awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of
we,
something
we
important.
Talk about how the libertarian men got no game. Sort of like me and Renee were getting all the lady play.
To read and sign the what Shire a shame. Society Declaration and learn the reasons. Yeah, I know. You love liberty.
You
should
immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself well, to babe, the Shire. Well, babe, you did better than Dale. And Blake. That's ShireSociety.com. That has to give you some kind of confidence.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. Before we left, we were kicking off the vendors at Hempfest. I had a great high time there. Like, that's the one thing I hate. Being places and being high and not getting to eat good food. Like, it pisses me off. Or eat it all. I get angry when I don't eat. Like, it's like I'm like the Snickers commercial.
Yeah. Well, before we hit those, though, during our magical journey in the beginning, we ended up going
on the magical journey is because we were down looking for food.
That's when we ran into Rick Naya.
And he took us on the VIP tour.
Yeah.
And the VIP tour was funny because when you're VIP, you're only VIP with Rick. Like, no one else pretty much cares because everyone's just hot. You're like, oh, you're VIP. Like, what is that? Like,
well, it was cool. Like we're sitting there in the VIP room tent or whatnot, and you're literally smoking Rich Paul under the table.
I know. I smoke everyone under the table. So he gave us like the grand tour just as we're like starving. He like brings us some fried pickles, like drizzled in ranch, and like that's beautiful because I hate places that don't have good food. And you know what? Like good food is important.
That was part of the miracle because we said we set out for food.
Yeah,
and then he didn't even know that. He's like, oh, well, you guys hungry? I'm gonna bring some fried pickles or something. Like he just brought them over. Like that was this part of our journey through finding.
Yeah, and that was awesome, and it was just great. I felt very free there. Even the vendors, I felt like we got everything we needed. Even though some things were a little pricey, but we did find Gandalf the Great.
Yeah, that was one of the best pieces. It was $20 too. It like was if you're watching on video at rebelloveshow.com, just look at this piece that we have right here. Like it was $20 and it was
that one was 15.
This is part 2. Yeah. That was unfortunate.
We got a discount because Gandalf the original
didn't make it.
He didn't make it. He was killed in the Great Ice Luge War of I don't need Liberty Forum 2015.
Did you say Ice Luge? Liberty Forum? But it's August. Why are we still going on about a fucking long melted block of ice?
I don't know, but apparently waiters care. So I mean, well, that's a thing.
Well, yeah, that's apparently a thing. But we did get Gandalf the Great, and I think that shows another great thing that happened at Hempfest. People were so genuine, and, you know, like, most people would be like, I don't know, especially people in, like, I guess this community would be like, people were commenting even in the chat. Oh, if he broke your glass, like what are you gonna do about it? Like blah blah blah.
Nothing.
Like, yeah, exactly. But people, you know, there were just like boo. Like forget this guy.
Oh yeah,
like,
there is campsites all around this booing him.
We told it what he did in all its entirety, and people were like, boo, it's not okay for you to damage other people's property. And like, and whatever you consider a personal vendetta, and you know what? That's the genuine truth. Like, who gives a shit as long as you're not hurting anyone? And if you start damaging and breaking other people's property, who wants you somewhere? Like, we don't want to see this guy at Porcfest. We don't want to see this guy at, like, Liberty Forum, like, knowing that if he's upset about something, he's just gonna like break it.
Yeah.
And I thought that was a great example of the reputation system at work. Like these people were like, no, this guy sucks, like boo.
It was so bad he ended up leaving like Sunday morning within a
yeah
few hours,
and
like
his best friend beat his ass.
Yeah, I don't know, that was kind of
yeah. And I almost beat his ass. Yo Todd, what's good? So where's your boys? This stupid asshole is so drunk he comes up and he's like kicking around all this glass, and I wasn't there for the original bowl breaking incident, so like once I heard, I was like, I'm sticking there because like I know they're not gonna do anything, and I'm not putting up with that shit. I don't care where I am. And this dude comes up and he's starting more shit, and then he's like in a fucking pissing match with us, and we're just like, fuck off, get out of our face. And he's like, where are your boys? You guys are skanks. Where are your boys? Where are your boys?
No, he said, you guys
fight.
Are whores.
Whores, whatever. And I'm like, where are my boys? You're not going near my fucking boys. Guess what? I'm the only one here who's gonna fight you like a man. And I got up and I'm like, what? And he's like trying to get around me. And I'm like, what? What do you gotta do? I told you I'm the only one here who's gonna fight you like a man. And he wouldn't do anything. And I was like, that's right. And then he's like, I'm going to stand my ground.
I know.
And
like,
then he
he's
left.
Like, like 3 years old. I'm going to stand my ground. And he just stood there. Get the fuck out of here, you waiter.
Fuck Rebel Love Show.
Well, anyways, let's talk about like some of the best moments instead of the downers. Well, that was funny. I thought it was, first of all,
let's talk about it, because I don't think it was like a downer. I thought it was hilarious that this guy worked up all this energy
made
to be
fucking,
so hateful.
Yeah, made
and
a fucking
then
fool
made
out
an
of himself.
Ass of himself. And then, you know, we didn't have to do anything. We didn't have to lay a hand on him. We didn't have to protest. Like, he did something, and, you know, his actions were judged by everyone around him. And guess what? He got booed off the camp.
You were
and I
ultimately
it was a great idea.
You were ultimately reimbursed for your bowl by his friend.
Yeah, and then we got a brand new bowl
you
by
were
the
got a re- owner.
Oh, by the way, yeah, the
Rich Paul bought you a replacement bowl.
Oh yeah,
before
that's
that.
True.
So
yeah, he did.
So much good came out of that.
And speaking
Rob
of the guys
Jolly.
That we did, yeah, Rob Jolly of Jolly Glassworks, they're blowing live. Like the piece, like he made right here, like this was made there at Hempfest.
Yeah,
which is
it was
damn
a
cool.
live. Glass blowing. Oh, and that's where Renee got her shirt. That is in the what is it?
My
the,
dare shirt.
The cover photo
drugs
for this.
Drugs are really excellent.
Drugs yes. are really awesome.
Or no, excellent.
Excellent. Oh. Dare. Fucking moron.
Whatever. Guys.
People are already making fun of you in the chat room.
I know. People are always making fun of me.
So
fuck you guys.
So what was one of your guys' favorite moments? Because there's a lot. I mean, discovering Zach Deputy.
The music madness. I like the music. I don't know. I guess I like the music. Some of it was good.
They had a range on it, but Zach Deputy blew it out of the water. I was so glad to see that twist. And lastly, that was the first time I even heard of Zach Deputy, let alone a song. You know, and to have it that Saturday night.
You should play one of his songs in the break.
Sweet Renee. Play Sweet Renee. He serenaded me. It was so cute. I met him 15 minutes before the show. And he was like, hey, what's your name? And I'm like, what the fuck is this dude hitting on me for? And he wasn't really, like, hitting on me, but, like, you could kind of tell. And I was like, what the fuck is this? And I'm like, who are you? He's like, my name's Zach. I go on in about 10 minutes. I'm like, oh, hey, Zach, what's good, buddy? What's your name? My name's Renee. I have a song called Sweet Renee. Will you play it for me? Okay.
Aww.
And then he played for me, and then I got a picture with him. And he's so cute. He's like a big old teddy bear. I just want to take his cheeks and just...
Yeah, he's adorbs. I really liked him, and he was, like, one of the only bands I really honestly listened to. Because other than that, I didn't really care much for
him. I wish the Alchemistics were there. They're great.
I don't know. Did you listen to more bands?
There's a couple other bands I listened to, but that was
Zach
really the
was
only
your
one.
Favorite.
Yeah,
and that was Disco sucked. That sucked.
No. You were that doesn't count because you're coming down.
No.
The Silent
that
Disco
mean
was
I
fun
don't
and
have
cool.
Taste in music. They were playing acoustic.
Not
music.
Not when I was in there.
Because
I was
the noise
in
ordinance at the Silent fucking Disco. And that DJ
what
was
are you talking
wrecking.
About?
That DJ was train wrecking.
When I was in there, there was different house music playing. There's different dance music. Like, there's different music being played.
I came in and out a few times, and I wasn't impressed. Whereas at Zion, they do
I wasn't
Zion
there
Disco,
to break
night.
This tie. I was not there to break this tie.
As
but
an inspir-
it looked cool. That's all I can say. It looked
oh,
like
yeah.
it was cool.
It's always a good time regardless because of the environment, but the music was not great comparatively.
I wish
great.
There was more, I don't know, I just wish there was better music, I guess. More music I liked. I don't know.
What did you expect from a hippie fest? Like, it's going to be
more
like hippie-ish
singing.
Music.
She wants Lana Del Rey. Yeah. What do you mean more
singing? What are you talking about?
You fucking idiot.
I didn't feel like anyone was, like, singing. I feel like it was all just, like, electronic and, like, people playing.
Was Zach Deputy was going on, like, you know,
no, Zach Deputy
from time to time.
Was, like, singing. No, like, it was true. Beautiful. It was, like, I could sit in the middle, I don't know, in the meadow and just, like, lie back. But
yeah,
everyone else, it was just, like, it didn't fit. I didn't feel the, like, vibe.
Yeah, even listening to him, like, passionately sing about collard greens. Like,
yeah.
That was beautiful.
Like, it was great. He was singing a song about, like, pissing. Yeah. and I was like, yes, this is awesome.
Penises.
Well, I mean, like,
just
for me.
Just a tip.
Well, just a tip was funny. For me, that was one of magical moments. Well, I'll really say why.
Okay.
Plug Zach Deputy. Break.
Yeah, go download him. It's awesome.
Yeah, Zach Deputy on Facebook. Zach Deputy everywhere.
Keenvention is coming up fast. October 30th through November 1st.
Keenvention.
Get your tickets now.
It's almost here.
Keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate
Renee,
event where you can
are you going to Keenvention?
I have a panel, dumbass.
Chris Reitman, you have a... Presidential candidate Renee Darryl has a panel. Radical agendas, Chris Cantwell.
Neocash Radio's Dr. Darren... What? Is it the sexist panel? Sylvia, rated an
A plus by the fuck NHLA. You, your sexist panel. Panel. Shows Rob Mathias.
Tech guru Brian Sovereign. Oh, that ego though just went through the roof.
Baby, your head can't afford to get any bigger.
I know,
I
saw
I
it expand. I literally saw it expand. You Persian fuck.
What are we even talking about?
Keenvention.
Oh,
now I have a ladies' panel.
The sexist panel. Are there any men on that?
No, go fuck yourself. My dog is more worthy to be on that panel than you because she has a vagina. So go fuck yourself.
You are so sexist.
What about our dog?
Riker has a penis.
Devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise.
Is it bad that
escape.
I hope Max dies?
Look for Survivor Max on Facebook.
I hope Max dies.
Who?
Max. From this book.
Why?
If you can't listen to the Liberty Radio Network's
internet. You're a bad person. That's what that means. Radio affiliates,
no worries. You can listen to LRN.FM from any phone, anywhere. Add this number to your phone. 213-493-0309.
It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Liberty Radio Network listen lines are locked into our stream 24 hours a day. Call 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move.
I remember when they were filming this. It's about, oh my God! To the entire country. So weird.
Yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market,
making it just a freer, great place to live.
I remember them filming
the
this.
Largest voluntarist libertarian That's community.
Well, both filming this.
What the fuck happened?
I remember him doing these. I remember him doing these interviews at Liberty Forum in 2014. No, 13.
I remember him.
13.
I remember 14, him doing no, 14. It when he was in the smoking
yeah,
room.
Across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire,
what the
people
fuck?
Are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com.
Yeah, thanks, Bob. Send me a bunch of pictures.
101reasonsfilm.com. DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers,
periodicals.
Software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware.
Hey, what do you want to hit up with next, babe? Grocery,
well, we were talking about
best moments. Yeah, I got to that. Like what your favorite moment was, what my favorite moment was.
Get all your okay, yeah.
Oh, my dolphin necklace. Goes to benefit the Liberty Radio Network. My when God, you I looked via so confusing when I was younger.
Well, we're
Music Madness.
I had what is Music Madness?
Then I found well, we were just talking mud. About all the good music and all the bad music.
Oh. So
I paid that's what I thought that, I that's why I was talking about it. My and magic mud is black tooth powder. That we're going to talk about. Arrival. Yeah, let's talk about the Rolling Saturday. And then we can go into
that can roll into the
the
if you enjoy LRN.fm, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. Before we left, we were going over what fucking crazy times we have at drug festivals in the middle of New Hampshire. So, back into Zec Deputy. The night we first heard him, we were rolling hard.
Well, we were trying to do a part two of the Big Gay Dance Party.
No, nothing. The Big Gay Dance Party is a solo act.
No. I'm saying in general, like, rolling
there
wise.
There can't
like,
be no part two.
We were saving it for the right moment, the right time.
Yeah.
You know, it's like we saved it for that moment, we saved it for this moment.
I don't see how you could do it more or just like on a frequent basis. Because I know a few people who do it on like a frequent basis. Like I
don't know how you do that.
It absorbs so much energy.
Yeah.
Like I literally feel like drained after. This time was better though.
Yeah.
Do drugs smartly.
Yeah. Like we save like stuff like that for like special occasions, festivals, or stuff like that.
Well, what I'm saying is drink lots of water.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And
yeah.
B1 vitamin is definitely an upper because I remember after Porcupine. Well, I was like dying sore.
Yeah, that Saturday.
Like,
yeah.
Everything hurt. Every bone in my body hurt. And this time, like, I woke up like, oh, but then I took some B1 and I was like, oh, okay. I'm fine.
That
ready
helped a lot,
drink.
Taking a B1. Take some B1 vitamins and kind of, like, multivitamins, like, after the next morning. It'll be great.
So, I think our goal was to actually roll a bit harder because we wanted to roll throughout the night.
Yeah, so I think taking a second smaller dosage in, like, an hour or so afterward.
Yeah.
The right way to do it.
Yeah, just like, you know, space it out right. And so when we first started, we're like, we didn't feel it. And I think it had a delayed effect because first time we were doing it out of fruit roll-ups and this time we got professional and did it the right way.
Yeah,
like, and I think that had like a prolonged effect because we were like at a certain point in the party just like, well, okay, we don't feel it. Let's take a bit more. And
yeah,
you know
like an hour in.
That's a mistake. Well, it was a mistake. It turned out well. But I'm like, oh my God. I'm like, these are going to kick in. They're going to kick in higher. Like, I was tweaking hard.
I would say it's not a mistake because each time we split done it, up. Each time
I don't,
we did that, though.
I don't know what you did for the rest of the night because for the rest of the night, I tweaked. Like, I was like, things were like disappearing and reappearing.
Oh, I was dancing my ass off at the silent disco.
Yeah, because you went to the silent disco to dance.
Yeah.
After we did it. I remember because it was our goal to do it on every drug. And I think that was my worst experience, like mushrooms, after mushrooms, after you are on mushrooms.
Well, that's a whole different story. Yeah, that's not my sex drug. Yeah.
No, mushrooms is no one's sex drug.
That was the worst thing to listen to.
What do you mean?
You weren't even there.
I heard everything. I was in Cody's tent, remember?
Oh, I thought you were talking about Hempfest. Would you be careful?
God, can we move out of this fucking house so we can get new fucking chairs? These chairs are broken. Someone in the chat room was like, oh, what a nice studio. I'm like, don't be fooled. Everything is broken.
It's all about the camera angles.
It's all just wired together by like gum. But no, this wasn't at Porcupine, Renee. This is at Hempfest because
we had a DJ like playing to us the whole time.
Yeah, we got really
lucky.
Which is
pretty cool.
It was like a light show.
Yeah. So like one that, because we're in the same tending area as all the artists. So one of the DJs, probably from the silent disco, was like literally playing in his tent right next door to us. And like he had a laser light show that like literally shot through our tent
and just lit it up. It was beautiful.
Yeah.
Like we had a disco tent. And anyway, so he went left me and went to the silent disco. And so I go outside and I'll tell you what happened on my journey. I go outside and like by this time it has definitely kicked in because we left Zach Deputy because of the stupid noise ordinances. Like you had to cut off the music by like 11.
It was such a good show. Everyone was dancing. At Zach Deputy, just to backtrack to that, I just remember that that's when I started rolling hard. That's when like it literally just kicked in, started like everything, like I could like colors were vibrating, I could feel music, like I can feel the warmth from like the love from everyone, like it's like intense. And you look forward and you just see lights coming everywhere, sexiest woman possible dancing with a hula hoop, you know. And I look to my left, there's people throwing flames up in the air. I turn around, there's people lighting floating lanterns going up into the sky. There's a moon over the mountains.
They're throwing like glow in the dark balloons.
And there's hundreds of us just like all like dancing together. Like you just go to any group you want to and just dance around with people.
Everyone,
it was incredible.
Everyone wanted to dance. Everyone was like ready to dance. Everyone was like, I feel the love. Like I hadn't even asked for booze the entire time I was there. Like in the middle of that dance floor, people were just handing me bottles of booze. Like here's some booze.
All right, kids, that's great. Everyone in the chat room is bored and now wants to hear about my Adderall.
Please.
Yeah,
taking
you
over your
problem.
Show. All right, Ian, you can play my bumpers now. Anyways, so since you kids are so curious, I'll fill you in.
Did you do Adderall the night we rolled?
Yes.
When wasn't she doing
okay,
Adderall?
That makes sense.
I was only there one night, you moron.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but when was
you're
she
just
doing
so
Adderall?
Unimportant. I just forget.
Yeah, I know, since that's what all our listeners think. Anyways.
You're not far off.
On to the real content. LOL, not my show. So
and we mute Renee's mic at this point.
So I got no, because then I'll start screaming.
Oh, I can. I got the button right here. Don't tap me.
Do what I dare you.
If you're good.
Yeah,
we
if
won't.
You're good.
If you're good.
Yeah, go ahead and do it.
You better be good,
I'll
Renee.
I'll pull a Mark Edge. I'll pull a Mark Edge.
Be good, Renee. Don't hit the bong when you pull the Mark Edge. Just don't hit the bong.
So anyways, since y'all are wondering, I get to this festival, and my first task, I gotta find me some Adderall. I'm trying to get fucked up.
This was her magic day one.
So I sit my ass down, and I'm like, I gotta find Adderall. Guess what? Adderall came to me. So I get a pill, but they're time released, and I hate that shit. So I'm like trying to like crush it up so it's like, you know, like I can make it instant. Guess what? It doesn't work that way. So I did one line at about 8 o'clock. I thought it was around 10. My phone was dead, so I didn't know because I was going to get high for the silent disco to go there and dance my ass off because that's what I do. I rave on Adderall. So I do my first line. I realize it's too early. I'm like, oh, shit, I guess I'm going to have to do another line right before the disco. So I'm all tweaking and I'm all excited. I came down right about 10 o'clock, so I did another line. I go to the silent disco. They're playing acoustic music.
So you didn't dance even once?
I No, I wasn't that enthralled, honestly.
You were enthralled enough to take a selfie.
You didn't take a selfie at the Silent Disco.
When I got to the Silent Disco, there was decent music playing, and there's a lot of people
dancing.
I just see Renee standing there in the corner, like...
I'm in the middle.
Looking as if the world just collapsed upon her or something like that.
The music wasn't that great, so it's not hard to believe her.
Right. So here's my thing. One, I've been to other festivals. I know what a good silent disco is. That was mediocre. It was sad. I wasn't impressed with the music. And I'm musically inclined as it is. So when you put me on Adderall, I'm very focused on what I'm hearing. And it just... There were a lot of parts. Like, if I hadn't been on Adderall, I probably wouldn't have noticed so much. I still would have found it mediocre, but I could hear it so clearly. It sucked. It sucked. That's why I go to raves and do Adderall, because it sounds even better. Like, Searle on Adderall. Oh, yeah. That's what I scream while I'm coming, 66. Anyways, that was another question I was asked. Anyways, so then around like 2 a.m. I did another line. And then around 6 a.m. I did another line. So guess who was awake for 36 hours and still drove home like a psycho and then had a major fucking panic attack? Yeah, never panic on Adderall. That was terrifying. Don't be awake for 36 hours. That was terrifying.
First of all, Renee, you suck at drugs. Because
Adderall is great. Adderall is my favorite drug. I overdid it.
But you weren't fun. Like, you're supposed to do drugs and be fun.
Yeah, because
like,
I overdid it. I didn't do it right.
Well, you were kind of fun. You weren't super fun.
Yeah, when I'm coming up, I'm great. But like when I'm coming down, especially when I crash.
Yeah, you crashed hard.
Yeah,
you weren't pleasant to be around.
Plus, like, my boyfriend and I were arguing over like nothing, and you drove like an asshole. So you caused it.
Okay, stop that.
You guys freeze. No one knows what the fuck you're talking about.
Fip.
Or probably cares.
Fip.
Okay. Fip. You have to drive with the flow of traffic. You guys were going like 30 miles an hour to 55.
The speed limit was 70. You were going 65.
And this is why these two always get tickets.
I was on your ass. Yeah, because I'm from Massachusetts and he's from Illinois.
Then why weren't you?
I was on
Why'd
your
you disappear?
Ass. That's why Bo was mad at me. Look, because you were driving 65 and a 70, and my boyfriend was like, "You're gonna cause a shit. You're drawing attention to us." And I'm like, "Suck a dick." And then I didn't want to argue with him, so I just listened to him, and it was terrifying.
Referee,
it was the worst drive of my life.
Referee,
way to throw him under the bus.
Wait,
that is all you.
Wait,
okay.
Referee,
yeah, that kind of was his fault. Sorry.
And
I did too much Adderall, and you drove like an asshole. It was all
the real tragedy here is that I fell asleep and Rob drank all of my pumpkin pie culotta.
Oh my!
And more when we come back.
You can't win if you don't enter, and you actually can improve your chances of winning a prize drawing.
Hey, I want to play the video of me being me and Ann here, being pulled over. Enjoy, kids. I don't think this will actually go through on the YouTube channel. I haven't figured out when it may or may not. Let me know. I'm over here. I'm over here.
How's it going? Got license registration, please?
Here's my license.
Why are we being pulled over? What did we do?
Yeah, why was I pulled over?
Excuse me?
Why was I pulled over?
I can't hear you.
Why was I pulled over?
You have no plate light.
What?
What?
Yeah. Can I have registration, please?
You have no plate light? What's a plate light?
I have no idea. Oh, God, that's really good.
Mm-hmm.
Well, left plate light, right plate
Here, I have two of them.
Which one's the newest?
This one. That one expired 2015. Well, then it'll be this one right here.
That one expired 2015.
I have registration for it. I don't know where it's at. But that's the latest one I have.
Are you Robert?
Yes.
Did you give me your ID? ID?
Yeah, you have my ID.
Thank you,
boy. As long as everything on that is valid, I'm going to sign it. If not, it's not valid until it's signed.
What's wrong with your plate light?
Bridge of Hot. Copy, Bridge of
Hot. Damn, that causes them to pull me over.
What the fuck is a plate light?
When you talk about your plate lights, you have two on your vehicle.
Okay.
You have a left one and a right one. You're required to both be working. Your left one is operational, your right one is out.
Then it must have just went out.
Okay.
Alright.
Am I free to go now?
No.
Okay.
I copy down your information, he's going back to deal with it now.
What do you mean to deal with it?
You're in violation of law, per the inspection manual. Both have to work. So he's going back and he's going to make a determination of what he's going to do from there. Okay, and then he'll come back up and talk to you about that.
Okay.
Alright. Does that make sense?
Not really. So it seems like a waste of it seems like a waste of time. It
seems like a waste of time?
Yeah.
Okay, why isn't that bulb working?
Why isn't what working?
The bulb.
How are we supposed to see the back of our car?
Like, I appreciate letting me know that it's out. I'll get it fixed because I understand the importance of it.
You know when it went out?
But to be...
It had to be just now.
This is the first time I've ever known it being out.
Have you ever checked
the lights on my license plate?
Any of them?
Well, I know the headlights in rear work because whenever I'm driving, if I go in reverse, I go forward, I see the lights sticking back and forth. So I know those are working.
And also, no one's ever pulled us over and said the light didn't work.
Have I ever physically got out of the car and walked around the entire vehicle to see if that light is on?
Yes.
Never even came to my realm of, like, thinking.
Okay.
That doesn't seem like something I would. That doesn't seem like what normal people would even do. I don't know.
What people would do.
To check to see if the light bulb on the license plate is on, is operational. How often do you do that?
How much? Well, my police cruiser I do daily.
Okay. Besides your police cruiser, your personal car. How often do you check the license? Once a what?
Once a week.
Once a week. You check the light on your license plate once a week?
All my lights, once a week.
Wow.
When I wash it. I know.
Well,
that's
does
awesome.
This car look
Congratulations.
Like? Does this car look like it's been washed?
What'd you say?
No, I said congratulations. That's well done.
All right.
I've never heard of that ever. Anyone ever saying that?
It happened.
This car has bird shit on it.
What the fuck? For a license plate.
Bulb.
I am being detained.
Yeah, just stop talking.
They're gonna see how to deal with it. Apparently they need to figure out what to do. Heaven forbid I have a light bulb out over my license plate. I need a new car.
Why do we're like 2 seconds away from our house.
I know.
I should have turned left.
We were talking about it in the car. I'm like, nah, we'll drive by, see what's going on.
Well, I didn't know that your left plate cars. Light was out.
Jesus.
Or else I would have been like, okay. This is so annoying. I just want to take a nap. We're going to be home in 2 seconds.
I know.
Now they're going to fine you $300.
What is this now? Like number 13, 14?
Now they're going to fine you like $300.
I know, for a license plate.
What the fuck is a license plate?
Apparently there's lights that come over it. I didn't even know.
This car doesn't have any license plates.
No, there's lights above it apparently.
Sorry, babe. Sorry, you've endangered the lives of millions
I'm endangering all the lives.
The millions of people.
I mean, forbid if someone can't see the half of my license plate in the middle of the night from behind me when they're shining headlights at it. I mean, they drive up behind it. I mean, don't their lights work? Like, I don't understand. Like, it doesn't make any sense as to why this is even a thing that I'm being pulled over for. First, I get pulled over for a goddamn sticker. Now I'm being pulled over for a light over my license plate. I can understand if, like, my headlights are out or, like, I'm leaking gas or dragging a bumper. Like,
just keep asking everybody free to go because I want to go home. I want to take a nap. Oh, that guy's lights work. Why can't you just obey the law?
I didn't even know that. How am I supposed to know all these little laws? Like, heaven forbid, I didn't know they enforce light bulbs being on over your license plate laws. I didn't know that was a thing that happened in New Hampshire. But
they do when your car says, fuck the police under it.
That's true. That's true. Oh my god, what the fuck am I doing? And why do they gotta shine the light right at you, too? Like, you can't see because of it. They do that on purpose.
It's an intimidation factor.
Yeah, I know. That's why, like, I'm like, I'm not gonna roll. You notice how I roll it all down? I'm like, wait, what the fuck am I doing? Why would I give them so much courtesy and roll the window all the way down?
I don't know.
They're probably gonna write me a ticket at this point. I guess, I'm tired of being I'm really, really tired of being a right to travel activist.
Well,
I hate this. This is not what I came to.
We need to sell the Bitmobile.
I know. I want to sell this goddamn car. I have ideas for bumper stickers, but they're not that what's on this car right now. And I took most of them off too.
You didn't take enough off them.
I'm too lazy. You can. You feel free to get back there and start.
Why would I do that? I love watching. I love getting pulled over by the cops for not having a light above your license plate. That guy gets out of his car and risks his life every day to walk around his car 3 times and make sure every light works. Like, he's a dedicated citizen. Manchester PD.
I've never heard of that.
How do you even check it? Is it just on all the time?
The only time I ever checked lights is, like, when I bought a car. That's, like, the only time I've ever, like, went and bought, like, checked the lights on a car when I bought it. But, like, when you're driving, like, you see the lights going forward. When you put it in reverse, you see the lights behind you. You can see the lights on the ground. Like, you see that. Like, I don't need to check it.
Robert, is your license and registration back? Here's a summons.
For what?
For not having your old plate light working.
Why would I take that? Like, I don't see what the issue is.
Your vehicle's not properly working, so the plate light's not
so
working.
Your so. Decision is to summon me to your court to steal money from me.
You can pay it, actually.
How much is it?
It is $44.64.
So you want to steal from me $44 because a light bulb went out on my car?
I'm personally not stealing anything from you, sir. That's a state.
That's what you're doing right now.
Okay, well, you can take it up with the state. You can request a court date, and I'll be happy to see
you. Wait, aren't you the state?
I'm an agent of the state, so...
So aren't I taking it up with you right now?
Okay.
Well...
You see what I'm saying? Like, I'm taking it up with you. You're representing them.
We'll see him in court. I want to go to bed.
Do you feel okay personally stealing from me $44 because a light bulb...
I'm not stealing anything from you, sir.
Yes, you are. Okay. What happens if I don't pay that?
Then you'll take the consequences.
And what are those?
Probably an EBW.
And what is that?
Electric bank warrant.
Okay. So would you personally kidnap me over a light bulb?
I'm not going to kidnap you, no.
No, you wouldn't do it?
No. But if you don't pay
but someone
it,
else would.
If you don't pay it and there's a warrant, then I'm glad to come get you.
So you'll come... Now, that warrant, knowing damn well that warrant would be issued over this light bulb,
yep.
You would still personally kidnap me.
Not kidnapping you, I'm taking you under arrest.
What's the difference?
So
you think... So you literally kidnap me over a light bulb. How do you sleep at night?
Also talking up, sending.
Oh, did I get called a pretentious bitch again?
Probably.
I'd be so happy. I love when people call me a pretentious bitch.
Because I am.
Called you a pretentious bitch? Well, that's no fun.
I'm going to go on the edge here. I don't like the new Google logo.
Yeah, me neither. I don't like change, period. I look so weird.
Oh, you want to see it?
I guess so.
What are you doing? Watching the left.
I don't see.
Your guys' camera angle sucked in that video.
Yeah. Fuck off.
You guys need to check that shit.
You need to check that shit for us, producer.
And the reason people were probably voting for Renee, spell my name right, Alan, was they were hoping you'd lose and show your tits. You got us crazy, as you know. After you said on Rebel Love Show you didn't get out of the car when you went to free the nipple because it was raining, I looked up naked pics of you. You get people so worked up. If I weren't so poor, I'd give you 100 Bitcoin. You do great shows. I love your freedom, perspective, and for Goddess and Renee, too. Alan, that's great.
Wow.
And
No, it's not.
No, it's great.
Where was this? Is this a
except
comment?
Except for you looking up naked pictures of me.
Yeah, that's a little weird. I'm not going to lie, bro.
Everything else I'm cool with.
They believe undermines evolution of sex. That's what Katie was watching.
I will take naked pictures when I lose like 25 pounds. Then I'll leak my name.
Is Alan Smith the guy that came up on the picture with you guys? That guy was a cool guy.
What guy?
No, is this Alan? This guy? Is this Alan Smith? Has he met you guys before?
No. Who the fuck is Alan Smith?
That's the guy who wrote the comment. Way to appreciate your fans.
Yeah, no, that's a hardcore fan. That guy sounds awesome.
You asked, have I met this person?
And okay, he's not that hardcore of a fan. And he didn't spell my name right.
No.
In fact, he spelled it terribly wrong.
Well, thanks for your comments and my tits. My tits. I appreciate that because I want to get a breast reduction.
Please, God, no.
I really want to get a breast reduction.
No, you're not allowed.
You can go down a breast size if you give it to me. Because sharing is caring.
That's
just
a
be
fair
a D,
trade.
Be a D, and I'll be a C.
I don't want to be a D. I want to be like a C.
No.
Then I'll have like a huge ass.
No, that's not fair. You still need to be proportionate.
No, I want like, you know that song by Kanye? She has an ass that'll swallow up a G-string, but up top, two bee stings. So like an A cup.
Yeah, it can be sweet.
I like girls with small tits. What can I say? Like, your tits are proportional.
Yours are very proportional.
Except, like, those little candy girl bra you wear. Like, you need to throw those away. Because you look like you're in, like, a pedophile's...
What?
Yeah, I have
best
no idea.
Dream.
Are you talking about, like, my raver bras?
No, the pink one you were wearing that time.
What pink one?
I don't know. It looks like a training bra.
I don't have any pink bras.
You have,
what
like,
the
pink
hell are you
trim.
Guys talking about?
I remember your bras specifically.
Pink trim.
Yeah.
This is what, like, living with women.
Pink
they go on these weird tirades.
Are you talking about my blue one? My navy blue
bras.
One with a pink bra?
I hear this all the time,
the dark
too.
Pink?
I don't know. It was the one I didn't like. It was the one I didn't like, I told you.
Oh, the pink with the little diamond in the middle,
yeah.
And it's got like coral. It's
yeah.
Coral color.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
yeah,
I didn't like that
I don't
one.
Wear that one very often. I only have like one pair of underwear that matches it, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I think pink can be good in lingerie sometimes, so. It just has
like,
to be like the right kind of pink.
Dude,
you need to wear some more lingerie. Dude.
Well, you need to buy me some more lingerie.
Okay. Well, I'm trying to get you a house right now, so
cheap.
I think that's a, you know, I think there's a better step than lingerie, but if you want more lingerie, we can do that instead and be here.
Well, babe, don't complain.
Elaborated several ways Bayer's strategy could have been more effective, including setting you better be able to pause that in like a minute, Renee, because we're coming back soon. I will not put Cyril on these wavelengths of LRN.FM.
and pleated trousers.
In other news, a jar of change on a dresser is sadly factoring into a number of financial decisions.
Renee, you're going to be sad you missed the rave this weekend.
How much you honk, it's not getting out of the road. And Dad's new 20-year-old Thai boyfriend really sucks.
What rave?
Friday.
And don't forget to never,
oh, a tin roof? That's not a rave. That fucking... No,
she's having an after party at her house.
Okay, then I'll go to the after party. Okay.
You gotta make friends at the event. Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show, and we're talking about best moments, but really leading into the...
Wait, can I ask you a big question, I think, because before I feel like we won't ask. Were you ever, since we talked about it on the last show, afraid that the festival would get raided?
Oh, me? No, I wasn't afraid it was going to get raided.
We had just talked about the Fish Festival.
That's true.
And how they got raided.
Well, there were parts during the festival where I kind of thought they might, but...
I don't know. It was like at one point it was just like maybe, but then there was such a bigger part of me that just didn't give a shit either. So I was like, I'm gonna try everything, like within reason, I guess. And someone offered us something we had never done before.
It's true.
It was a special K.
Yes.
And you know, I had never done it before. I had mixed feelings because I was planning on doing other stuff later in the day. But I was like, hell, why not? I'll try it. So we tried it, and it was just like a little upper.
Yeah.
It's like a little upper.
A little bit more awake. That's about it. It wasn't intense,
but it was like as if you were to drink an energy drink.
Yeah, I wasn't that.
But a drug. But anyway, so that was I think one of my faves that I did.
That was your favorite?
Not like more than MDMA, but like favorite new thing, I guess, like because I liked it. But my worst probably, well, I guess I say you on shrooms was the worst.
What, me on shrooms was the worst?
No, like after shrooms because like... You know, when guys do shrooms, like, they can't get hard for a while.
Their dicks don't work.
Yeah.
My dick don't work. Come on, Kanye, just get it, man. My dick don't work, man.
Like, dicks don't work. Shrooms suck. Like, and then, like, it's like, not only do they not work anymore, it, like, works negatively. You're like, Jesus, like, I've never seen it, like,
Rob's
so
embarrassed
hard.
Right now. His dick is, like, a turtle.
I remade
like,
that back.
Yeah, it was. Day. I was like, what? So, shrooms wasn't the best.
It was still a good trip for me, so.
Yeah, it was a good trip. I'm glad
you know what's
had a
great?
Good trip.
Fuck on Adderall. Yes, dude. I am, like, the goddamn Energizer bunny when I do me some Adderall and then hop on a dick. I will tell you right now.
No doubt.
Well, that is my shit.
I felt like I should have been... I felt like I was, like, on MDMA, but, like...
No, we should have done it sooner. We waited too long. Yeah, absolutely. We
should.
As soon as Zach Deputy stopped, we should have.
Yeah,
that should have been the moment.
You. We'll
that
time it been better.
The moment. Yeah, yeah. Next time we will.
No, but before that, so Rob, I think you win the medal for most illegal substances ingested at this festival because you did everything.
Well, yeah, the shrooms and also the edible. Yeah, yeah. Which was a bad edible trip. I've done I've done edibles a lot.
I always have a bad trip on edibles. If you've ever heard me talk about edibles, every time I do edibles, I get violently ill and I throw up.
I had a great streak for like 3 or 4 of them where it was just a fantastic trip. It was a good body high. Like everything felt great. Like everything. You know.
That happened once, but then it's like I always get dizzy or something at the end.
This one, I had to lay down. I was sweating. You know, I felt like I had to throw up.
And at first you thought it didn't work.
Yeah, it kicked in like an hour and a half, 2 hours in. Normally, I feel something in like 45 minutes.
But it was all bad. I felt like it.
Yeah,
like
I didn't enjoy.
Have,
I didn't
like,
enjoy it
good,
at all. It was not enjoyable.
I like
all.
How
I
they're
regret.
Calling it a bad trip.
What? Why?
Why? Why?
You don't trip on pot.
It's not a trip, but
what? What do you call it then? It was a bad
time.
No, it was. It feels like a trip because your body's like floating, and you feel like violently ill.
All right. Well, there goes my camera angle. Renee thanks, now doesn't Ash. Have a camera. All right. Bye, guys.
See, you shouldn't be talking bad about. Oh, there she is on camera. All right, that was funny.
It's not moving my fault. Your fucking cat is like retarded. Like.
Yeah.
Well, I felt bad for my poor baby. I took care of him.
You know, see, my big fear was that happened. Saturday morning.
Yeah,
and we were already planning out the MDMA trip.
He ate the brownie for breakfast.
My breakfast. Yeah.
Idiot.
He had eaten, but like he got sick, and we were like, "It's okay, babe. Like I'll take care of you. You'll get better before tonight, so we can do some more drugs." Like, and if it was me, you know, he would have left me.
No, I would not have done that. No, I would not.
Babe, I really want to walk around the festival. Please, babe, would you be mad?
What do you do at Porcfest when you were like throwing up everywhere?
Wait, you were throwing up all over at Porcfest?
Yes. Exactly.
You left me at the hotel.
Oh. Good job, Rob. Good job. I can. That's some quality boyfriending right there. That's some
Beyonce. He was like, throw up all over here. Like, he does hold my hair when I get.
I've offered.
You've offered. You're okay.
Okay.
You're okay-ish.
All right. Thank you.
So, did you have any life-changing moments while you were doing one of the many
I definitely did. I had a couple, but definitely one big one.
What was your big life-changing moment or, like, greatest experience?
Well, I had two.
Okay, tell both of them. Tell me.
First off, I just remember going back to, like, the height of my... MDMA roll. the apex of the roll. And you had it wrong device.
Oh, Anne's high.
So anyways, I remember just rolling really hard and looking around like, love dancing. So that's a big one. I want to go to more, like just dance more, but B, and learn how to be better at it. But the other life-changing moment is I really love festival life. Like festival life is fun. Like I want to do more of that. I want to get into doing that more. Like I kind of want to plan it out where like we go to like one festival a month. Like every one weekend a month we hit a festival.
So can we talk about this?
Yeah.
You guys have not even scratched the surface of festival life. To me, that was nothing at all. That was like an excuse.
Oh my God.
Well, not to say it was a bad time. It was a good time, but it wasn't. It was like. Zach Deputy was there. That made it a festival.
Well,
that was it.
I do want to go to another festival with better music.
Well, I definitely want to go to Wormtown. I just don't think it's going to be in the cards.
No, it won't be Wormtown.
I'm going. You guys said you were going. You guys suck.
Well,
sorry.
We know.
Fun.
This is what happens to fucking festival people. They're all like, yeah, festy life. And then they come home and they're like, oh, yeah, we have to be normal. No, I don't give a fuck. Ever.
You think we want to be normal?
You know
you
how I quit my last job?
Home and be
you know
wait,
how
are
I
we
quit
normal?
My last job, you guys? I was at the beach and you know what I did? I don't want to fucking go to work. So guess what I didn't do? I didn't go to fucking work, and I enjoyed the beach, and I had a job again 2 days
later.
Yeah.
I did.
Thanks to
me.
What are you going to do when we all lose our jobs,
too? I did the exact same thing.
Well,
I did the exact same thing. I was at Pumpkin Festival chilling at the CAC. I literally emailed my boss. I quit. Within 3 days, I got two jobs, one of which is a great job I got now. I did the exact same thing.
Well, I guess you guys are trying to tell me something here.
No.
Yeah, I am. I don't give a fuck. You want to quit your job? Quit your job.
No.
Then we have to whore ourselves for money.
Well, you can get away with that. We're in Manchester and...
What does that mean? We're in Manchester.
We walk outside
the
whoring
capital of the world.
We're solicited like every time we walk out.
Yeah, but those guys are broke.
You guys, I was walking back up into the house last night and we're in the fucking hood. Like, I walk in.
Well, no, first off, you call attention to yourself.
Hold on.
So
short skirts.
Yeah, the other night I was trying to give people change. But last night I didn't do anything. I was just walking up and this guy's like, hey, what you doing tonight? I'm like, I'm going home. He's like, hey, you got a man? I'm like, yeah, I do. And then he's like, oh, well, that doesn't matter. Come have a good time. I'm like, actually, I'm engaged. And then he's like, still doesn't matter. Come have a good time. And then I was like, actually, I'm carrying his baby. And he was like, oh, it was like boy repellent. So now I'm just going to tell everyone that I'm like pregnant.
That is super creepy. But you know what? I felt very safe walking the streets of Hempfest.
Oh, yeah, everyone's really loving there.
I really felt in a secure environment. I think I should just move to a commune. Would you be down? Commune life?
No.
Yeah, I'm actually be down for it.
What about a compound? Chill with communists.
Okay, so how did Hempfest compare to other Liberty festivals, you ask? Did you? Well, we'll tell you anyway when you come back.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update.
You guys, the chat room just hates you. $2 higher at $1,122. But I love it.
They're eating you up, Renee.
They are.
Yeah, all your ego. Renee.
The topic always returns in a whoring one's self after Bitcoin.
That is mainly the topic of our show.
How much Bitcoin would you guys sell yourself for?
I don't know. It has to be a lot. Actually, a lot. What about 100 Bitcoin? 100 bitcoins gets you one tip.
That's wow.
One tip.
You are pricey.
I've gotten a lot more for less.
Do you know how much 100 bitcoin would be?
Yeah.
How much?
I don't know. Is it like 275 right now, right?
Yeah. So add two zeros to that.
Exactly. So, but this is the thing. I have
so
to show
you. So $275,000 only gets me a nipple.
I have to show you my tip because you want a service. You want to pay for this service and my tip. This is the price of the market. Like, if I wanted to show you my tit, maybe I charge you less. But I don't want, if I'm just going to show a stranger my tit and they're going to pay me for it, like, obviously I'm going to let the market speak, you know?
What about 200 Bitcoin?
200 Bitcoin?
Yeah.
Both tits.
All right, how much for the whole enchilada?
What do you mean? Just seeing it?
No.
Okay. For the whole enchilada, I'd settle for a summer house in Cali, a lake house in Belize, and 200 Bitcoin. It's an easy way to spread
the ideas of liberty a bit further. Okay. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie. It's a good deal. I'll allow it for that.
Facebook.freetalklive.com. Hi, I'm Derek J.
Hi, I'm Derek J.
What's your price, babe?
I'd probably settle for 175 Bitcoin.
175 for the whole enchilada.
Yeah.
What does Renee love? Searle?
What's
dogs,
Renee's price? You ask. Renee would charge
10 Bitcoin.
A millibit.
Renee would charge rave 50? Tickets and plane tickets to Australia to go see Searle.
Fair enough.
And everlasting gas money to go see her dog.
Everlasting gas money.
Everlasting gas. And plane tickets to Australia to go to NH Nation.
So you know what you have to do to sleep with the Rebel Love crew. Everyone's a whore with a price.
And
Jesus, I wish we had that conversation on air.
Well, I'm still going off the YouTube.
What else am I obsessed with? Now that you've found the
Liberty Radio Network at RN. Isn't this the long commercial?
No. That was at the top of the hour.
Oh.
Starts in like a minute or two.
I'll bring it back in.
Where are we bringing up to? Okay, yeah, that's right. For your website, as well as files that will allow
you to make your own custom banners and graphics. Visit promote.com. You like my sign?
Yeah, I was watching when you typed it. The Liberty Radio Network. That's promote.lrn.fm.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing
necessary supplies. This is not as hot as it was earlier. And emergency
equipment. Dude, so is simply taking
responsibility for ourselves down. And our families when it counts. Enjoy it while it lasts, Renee.
Strategicshelters.com offers
emergency it. Send it soon.
It's almost gone. Hopefully we're in a big ass.
This is gonna be my
welcome
last
to New Hampshire. That's fine.
My hair. To find out what happened? More, visit strategicshelters.com.
Yeah, that's perfect. You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm.
That's cam.lrn.fm. Yeah.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. Before we left, we were talking about Liberty festivals in general and, you know, just how they compare. Renee was telling us how she had been to several, like, raves and music-type festivals in the past, whereas this has been, like, I guess being your first time or
it's my first music festival. Yeah. But, I mean, Pork Fest is similar to it.
Kind of. But I just wanted to see, like, how they really compared because I consider everywhere we go, even if it's a convention, like we're spending a weekend there, even if it's not in a tent. So we're going, and we went there to record a show, though that didn't happen.
Which didn't happen. That's it'll prepare on both camps, our side and their side.
So I mean, I guess
for next year, if next we're gonna, year definitely will record there.
Yeah, if we're gonna compare and contrast, I think that's the good thing about, you know, Liberty Festival is they're really organized and set up. I mean, I've been to some that weren't, but they were like shorter, I guess. Whereas I felt like this one, could have, if they wanted us to do the show, or other news and media there, which I guess they didn't want to promote it for whatever reason on like local or.
Well, I don't know. I see what you're saying, but we're kind of like they didn't have the like the VIP stuff like that, like the banner or something.
It was just all free range. It was very free, which I loved because that's, I think this is how it really like changed my life, I guess, in a way, the festival. Like Porkfest changed my life in a way. Like I was like, oh, I left Porkfest. I'll never be the same. I left Hempfest and I felt like very, like, okay, it put life into perspective again because it had been so long since the last.
Oh, it was a much needed reset on stress.
Yeah.
For sure.
And, you know, every time I go to, like, these Liberty events and you get to hang around these people that are, like, I don't know, you meet new people, everyone's really excited about everything, just being here and hanging out together. And I think that's, you know, the best part of these, like, festivals and events. And I think that's how they grill like each other in a lot of ways. Like social interaction is needed and people being free in that social interaction is not very coerced or anything.
Well, I mean, just like with how Porkfest, I went to Porkfest. I didn't go there for like all the talks. I went there just to hang out with all the cool people. Like convention, yeah, the talks are going to be great, but I'm going there to hang out with a bunch of cool people.
You have a panel.
I'm on three panels.
You're not really going to hang out
anyway. I'm working
anyway.
It. Yeah, oh, but three panels. Nonetheless, yeah, I'm working it. But.
And that was a big difference. We didn't work either because we did shows at the other.
Yeah, true. But even then, the amount of shows we did were small. I mean, I didn't do that much work at Porkfest. But what I'm trying to say is,
you did a lot of work at Liberty Forum.
I did too much at Liberty Forum. I ain't doing that again. That was way too much. I had like two things a day. That was way too much.
I was getting high.
Yeah, you're lucky. But just like how I went to Porkfest, not for the talks and convention, anything else, like Hempfest, I didn't go to Hempfest for the music. Like it was a bonus with a couple acts and stuff like that we saw. But I went there just to hang out with people. As if, yeah. You know, you're camping in the forest.
I made lots of new Facebook friends at Hempfest. I was getting everyone our Facebook. We gave people our cards. We didn't bring enough cards. I think we should have been getting everyone our cards. Like, who gives a shit?
Oh, yeah. Well, we were kind of rolling really hard. Invited everyone over to our VIP party at the tent.
Well, I know I made a lot of Facebook friends, and that's what matters because it's like it's not only, you know, meeting people, it's like staying connected, and you got like means to do that, and that's fucking awesome. So, I mean, if I could see one thing I like to see happen at next year's Hempfest, I mean, I guess definitely the campsite because the owners were, I didn't like them.
Yeah,
I don't
the
like
venue
them.
Totally blew.
Yeah, they were douchey. Yeah.
Oh, no, it definitely blew, like, hard.
If there would have been one more tent, there would not have been enough room for everyone.
Yeah, there's literally nowhere to actually.
Good thing we moved our tent to make room for that fucking douchebag.
Yeah, but that we didn't even say about, like, it had a lake, river.
Yeah, there's a river that was nearby that people.
It was right on, like, it was literally right by a campsite. We just had to walk down and river. That was awesome. So, and people were skinny dipping in it, and no one gave a shit. Everyone
yeah, there was
naked.
So much more nudity at Hempfest than there was at Porkfest.
Yeah.
It was more allowed.
And there were
like
hippies.
Yeah, and there were kids. There were kids. I remember at the dance party, like dancing with one of the little boys. He was like my spirit animal.
Yeah, and the father had a penis painted
just
on
like
his shoulder.
Just like a giant penis.
That dude had a child.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good
and
fucking
he was,
God.
And he was dancing with us in the middle, and he was like, he was having so much fun. He was like
good
jumping
God.
Up and down, like having the fucking time of his life. What's so wrong with that? Like, he's going to remember that for a while, for the, probably ever. That probably was an inspirational moment. And
you may have changed this kid's life with your with your dancing moves.
With my boobs. Great.
Good job, Anne, corrupting all the children.
Yeah. We were jumping high, too, because I was rolling. But
yeah, yeah.
Ridiculous.
I had the energy of a little child. I don't even remember. But anyway, if I could see one thing
change,
I guess it would be just the new venue. Like, I like the lake and everything, but fuck that. Like, those people charge $20 to use the bathroom.
Yeah, that was only open, like, what? Like,
it was open from, like, 12 to 6. So if you had to use the bathroom after that, like, you were just shit out of luck. Which, you paid $20 to use the bathroom. Yeah,
fuck that. I'll just pee in the wilderness. It's cool. Just bring paper towels.
Some people at this table decided to purchase that.
Well, I'm sorry if I can't use your porta potty.
You're so high and mighty. Like
peasant shit. Like, no.
So high class.
Porta potties are gross.
I can't use a porta potty. I gotta go.
Okay, Porkfest had bathrooms everywhere. There were multiple bathrooms. They weren't fancy bathrooms, but they were indoors, like decent civil human beings.
I'd like to see Hempfest go to Lancaster.
Really?
Rogers, yeah, just we're there again. I love that location.
That's like breaking a car and then buying the exact same car that you had just like broken.
Oh, hey, what's up? That's literally what I did. So
yeah.
Exactly.
Like, your point?
Like that is like no, they don't need to have it at Lancaster. They need to have their own original spot.
That's not
spot.
A good venue for it, anyways. Honestly.
Yeah.
We'll have to see other venues. But all I'm saying, I hope they keep it near the White Mountains.
They don't allow
the
nudity at Lancaster. Isn't it Lancaster who doesn't allow nudity?
It's not. It's not them. It's just
local ordinance.
Porkfest douchebags.
Yeah.
Aw. Porkfest douchebags.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, anyway, and if they keep anything the same, I think it should just be like how carefree it is, because really, this is a festival about marijuana.
Well, I hope that whole feeling stays. Like that, all things aside, with stuff that we didn't like about the festival. Like, I love that festival. It was a great time.
Rob is never going to say anything bad about anything ever. Like, everything was great.
No, I mean, there's some stuff that was kind of shitty, but that happened there, like the noise ordinances. Like,
well, we got to get rid of the state.
Well, absolutely,
us to take
them. These local tyrants think that they can tell people to turn off music at a music festival. Like, it's supposed to be music playing 24/7. It's a music festival.
Yeah.
You know?
You go to the main stage, like, at least in my experience, you can go to the main stage anytime. But I feel like the ideal time to go to the main stage is, like, anywhere between 9 and 10, because those are when the good acts come on usually. They save the best for last. And then I walk down there at like fucking 9:30, and like Zach Deputy's walking off the stage, and I'm like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
And they're like, sorry, we got a noise ordinance, sorry. What the fuck? Anyways, I'm out, you guys. This is my last segment.
Bye, Renee Cake.
Gotta get stuck
in ice cream.
Bye, Felicia.
When we come back, we'll talk about Rob and his victories against the Manch PD. Oh. Or are they?
I don't think so.
We'll see.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall
Street
insider.
Are you seriously not going to get my
ice cream?
I'm
holding a book
that
will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire,
fucking show
you need
shame,
to read this book.
Man.
If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers,
did he respond back to you?
No, he did not respond back to that email.
The strategy I used to make a 72%.
You can let go of that. I'm not going back to that camera angle. You can lay it down. Don't let
you'll
just
need
lay
at
down.
At least $1 million to ever fully retire.
Okay,
if you're behind
on
that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the
Sorry,
Pros.
Sorry, tell the chat room I said
can for free by calling 1-800-944.
Jesus, your roots are already showing.
Shut up, bitch! I know. I need to do something.
It's a free book, so what do you
I dyed it a while ago.
That was not
I
that
thought that
long
was
ago.
Natural hair color, Renee.
Yeah,
are you a fake blonde?
No, it's dirty blonde at the top, which is why your hair looks dirty.
Oh, you're a brunette.
No, it's not brunette.
Free Press Publications is an
even your eyebrows aren't real, are they?
She doesn't even have eyebrows.
With the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom
okay.
movement. Wait, you want to fucking see my eyebrow like,
peace, don't freedom, dye your hair yet. Wait till I get new extensions.
FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material.
Sorry.
You are overdue for doing a new hair color.
No, keep it blonde until after the wedding. Well, as a daily
5-minute newscast, that's a year. That's like 4 Shire years from now.
Weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace Love Liberty Radio at fppradio.com.
You do it. You be in competition with Ashley.
Newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc.
What the fuck is that reference? I don't understand.
Don't you know anything?
Are you younger than Anne?
Only thing I know is you said you were gonna get me ice cream, and there's no fucking ice cream in my mouth right now.
Sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forum. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook.
That's what we talk about. Just why everyone deserves to be shamed.
Every month, so drop in and say hello.
I'll
stay
on
the shame. I'm sure you will.
Proud to announce our official listening app for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for lrn.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to lrn.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm.
I do the same.
That's
for you.
apps.lrn.fm.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am
so let's
now
go into the
listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm.
Going to being pulled over.
Show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on doing the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at lrn.fm.
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. And so earlier this week, during the weekend, myself here and my Rebel Mistress, we were out partying with some friends and then on our way home. And we were detained for...
As fucking always.
Yep.
We need a new car.
I know. It's
like,
on the agenda.
We're already shady enough. Like, you got your, like...
The fuck you, you know, police. Fuck the police.
Fuck
car.
The police with your, like, long beard. Not being racist or anything, but you kind of look a bit Middle Eastern over there. And then you got a black girl in the car with you. In a fuck the police car.
Yeah.
In a fuck the police car. Like, how... Babe, you're just asking for it. You might as well
get pulled over, like,
be wearing
every month
a short
on the...
skirt on the end of cedar, like bending over, saying "Give it to me," because they always fucking come.
Yeah,
and you know what?
They do. You've learned well.
This is the thing I've learned. This is my life lesson that I've learned for the rest of these months. You know, don't second guess yourself, because we were sitting in the red light and we were like, you know, should we turn? Like, should we just turn here and not go by them? You know, we were like, nah, fuck that. We don't have any drugs on us as we did before we left. So whatever. Like, what can they get us for? Like, the worst they have to do is look at our car. But I was wrong. You know, I was wrong because they don't give a fuck. They will try to get you for anything.
Yeah, so no, absolutely.
We went, what?
Especially if they hate you. I mean, just ideology, like, oh, they hate me. I'm pretty sure, like, my car has been discussed in detail. It's like around the water cooler or something at this point.
Yeah.
Based off the amount of times I've been pulled over in Manchester.
Yeah. I bet they seen the Bitcoin thing. They were like, I'm going to get this fucker. And so we drive down the street, which we should have turned. We had the opportunity. Next time we have the opportunity to not drive by cops, let's just go to other.
Life lesson. If there's anything that's learning hospital, use this video or anything that we're talking about. When you have the ability to swerve away from a cop, you do it. Just do that. All right.
I love the cop disobedience because everyone's on point. Like, I was riding with Renee to Mass the other day, and Renee's a horrible driver, as you all might have heard before. Yeah. But the one thing she did good, like, there was a cop that she seen as we were driving up. She fucking flashed her lights all the way down the highway, like, warning oncoming traffic that the fucking pigs are up there. And that's important. You need to let people know because they literally, okay, we haven't even told you what they...
in some places.
We didn't even tell you why they stopped us.
Oh, yeah.
Like...
Well, listen, well, first off, what was really crazy, and we actually didn't notice this while it was happening, but after watching the video, I noticed it. There were two police officers. One was a statey, and the other one was a manch PD, which is really odd. I've never had that happen
before.
They
had just pulled over another car.
I've never been pulled over by two different divisions. It was one car, but it was two different divisions, like, doing the same work together. I don't know if it was a training or, like, they're observing. I have no idea.
They're trying to make
odd.
A quota.
And it almost seemed like the statey was, like, you know, the one, like, instigating the gets tickets. I don't know. But, the stupidest reason that I got pulled over.
I think they were trying to find anything, because when we first asked them, they didn't say anything. And, of course, we kept asking, because we're us.
Yeah. And then they finally go, oh, there's a light bulb out over your license plate. That little, inside the bumper, above the government-issued identification plate that I'm required to display, a little tiny bulb, you know, an inch long, is out.
No, the left one, because the right one still worked, that illuminated the fucking license plate.
It's
but
not
the
like
left
the car
one...
behind has headlights that will illuminate the entire back of the car.
Yeah, because that. So that is literally why we got pulled over. Like, we asked this guy, like, are we being detained? He's like, no. Well, can we go? He's like, well, no. And then he goes around to the back of the car again. Like, and then he's trying to, like, tell me turn down my window, which I'm always the recorder. I don't even know if I should bring this up.
Yeah, you record a lot now.
I'm always the one who's recording, and, like, people are like, oh, I seen Rob Mathias in that video, and Renee. I'm like, oh, I didn't see you. I'm like, who you think is holding the camera and bringing the lit? It's always me. I'm like the den mother here.
You're in the background.
You should have handed... the cop some cop lock lit. There was some in the car. You should have done that.
I should have educated those fuckers. Yeah. Because, okay, so it's always roll the window down a little bit.
You never give them any respect for doing that, because why would I show someone who's holding me up at gunpoint? If I tried to, like, just go home, they're going to shoot me. So why would I give them any kind of respect? On top of that, a person that would do that, you know, I'm not going to, like, feel safe having my window all the way down where they can grab me or do anything, like, open the door.
And
so
here's something I commend about my fiance here. Like, he literally genuinely hates cops. Like, he doesn't give a fuck. He can be high off his ass, drunk off his ass. If a cop comes up to him, he's still going to go at it with
him. Just get pissed off.
Like, he's just like, fuck the police in all situations. Forgetting I can't drive.
And, like, I know, yeah.
I'm just, like,
drive.
Planning for the day he gets arrested for, like, yelling at the cops because... he's drunk, but luckily you put the window down, like, over your breath.
Yeah, I put it. I was not drinking when I was in that car. I was fine, kids.
No, yeah, he was fine.
I was
fine. Like, it doesn't matter. Like, anytime you have the opportunity to tell a statey, like, you know, fuck off, like, you're robbing from me, because you know what their answer will be every time. It's not me.
I mean,
I'm not the one doing it. Like, you need to make them realize that they are.
Well, I do put the videos out whenever I record almost every interaction I have with police, and it seems like once a month at this rate. I'm exaggerating, but that's pretty damn true.
You were due.
And I try different things, but a lot of times I just go to straight up, I'm pissed off that you're stealing from me, and I want to confront you, human being to human being, that you're stealing from me, and you're threatening to literally kidnap me and throw me in a cage over a light bulb about my fucking car or a sticker or what have you. Now, take it as it would be. I say use it as a learning house. Well, tell me, give me some criticism. What should I do differently? I literally had this opportunity to like be, record cops, not even like looking for it, just like coming to me. I'm like a cop magnet at this point, which is disturbing.
You know what I think we should do? I think we should just have a trunk full of lit. And every time, no, it has to be in the car. If you try to get out, they'll shoot you. We have to have it in like the back seat, and every time they pull us up, like, you still do your same routine. How do you sleep at night? Because that's always what he yells at the end. How do you sleep at night, you fucking stady? But that's always what he yells towards the end. They always end up like dropping whatever their ticket they're trying to write us.
I'm not gonna give them that respect.
Yeah, they always want you to take it. They're like, here's your ticket. A fucking $45 ticket for an $8 light.
$44.64.
And 64 goddamn cents.
Exactly.
That's like his Christmas pay. He's trying to rack it in.
And on top of that, I love how the cop. He's like, well, you have to take that up with the state. I'm like, you are the fucking state.
Yeah,
you're working for them. You're issuing it, and I have to take it up with somebody else. You're the one doing it. Like, that doesn't make any sense. I love how like I came up with like you are the fucking state.
And then you ask him if like he kidnaps you, and like I love when like you say that to police officers because they're always like, what? I'm not kidnapping you. Like, what are you talking about?
I'm arresting you. That's what we call kidnapping here at the police.
And then you, like, explain it to them, and they were like, then they're like, okay. And then you ask, are you okay with kidnapping me? And they're always like, yeah.
Yeah. They love it. Like, that's what they're paid to do. Their paycheck comes from the ability that they will, if someone above them tells them, now mind you, they'll have to put on a piece of paper, like, you know, to make warrants out. But as long as it's on paper, they're more than okay kidnapping people for victimless crimes, well, left and right. That's they're okay with that.
I think,
and then call it arrest, of course. Don't call it kidnapping.
I think that's the high point of it all, because not only we pull out our cameras, we whip them out, we're always having them ready to tell them off. We need more lit, but not only, it's usually we take it to court. Always.
Yeah, I've won 2 court battles now. Probably I'm due to lose, so I mean, I'm probably going to be out this one.
I don't think so. I think you got a great case.
Well, I have a backup plan. Don't let my secret go out. My winning secret to winning this case, which I will win.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, Radical Agenda's Chris Cantwell, Neocash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, The Seditious Sirens, The Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, Tech Guru Brian Sovereign, Cop Blocker J.P. Freeman, New Mover Doc Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand Minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hello Keen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info.
Ian's doing right, pimping out that party.
Look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. If you want to play online poker with Bitcoin, you need a site that's trustworthy and technically sound. The site managers of swcpoker.eu have proven their commitment to bringing you great gameplay from a site you can trust, swcpoker.eu. They have lots of new games too, including Chinese poker and their Krill leader.
Murdoch's been really busy.
Man,
he does a lot of shit. You're making this look pathetic up here. Now and have some fun with your Bitcoin. For those out in the listening world, go to Facebook and check out Murdoch Biscotti. He's like a super activist down in Texas. He's been on the show before at Porkfest.
Liberty Radio Network via the cam feed in high quality 24/7, even when there's no live show being produced in our Keene studio. But wait, there's more. Our chat room is built into the cam page so you can interact with other listeners online. Listen, watch, and chat. All free at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You've heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25%.
We need to set up an Amazon thing on Rebel Love Show.
To live.
Okay.
I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you
You're more than welcome to set
Bitcoin.
One up.
You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveitpurse.com.
Look at the camera angle now.
The three most important things you can do.
It's actually kind of cool.
Are, one, let your friends know you're listening to LRN.FM on your social networking profile. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.lrn.fm. Three, $5 a month to the AMP program at amp.lrn.fm. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same great prices, and LRN gets a cut. Please do your online shopping at shop.lrn.fm. If you have a business, you know that IT can be frustrating, but it doesn't have to be. IT can serve your needs reliably, predictably, and on time. Rootwork Infotech helps businesses achieve always-on reliability. Their nerds know business and can meet your needs. To prove it, they'll give you 30 minutes on the phone with a senior consultant for free to answer any of your IT questions.
Should we put the next episode on hiatus if we're moving? I don't know if we can get this entire studio up and running.
Your free call. That's R-O-O-T.
Take a week off.
IT slash
or worst case scenario, Dale's.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with a chip in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. Before we left, as always, fuck the police. They're always pulling us over for anything. They literally pulled us over for our left license plate light bulb being
apparently
out.
There is a market now for license plate light bulb activism. So if someone else wants to join the cause with me, be down for the struggle,
and
knock out one of the lights above your light license plate and drive around at night with me and see what happens.
When's your court date? Because I don't think you announced it.
I got to send it back in. I don't have a exact court date or whatnot.
Okay. So yeah. Hopefully they just like sing you a date and then, you know, he'll record it and we'll see what happens. Hopefully he doesn't get arrested.
Well, I hope I don't have to use the camera. All right. Just like how people say, I hope I never have to use a gun. When I go into court, I hope I don't actually have to use the camera, because that happened last time. That's how I won. There's a reporter there with a press badge and a camera. And they saw that, and I think that was the reason why they just threw out the case.
I hate going to legal. I hate going in government buildings. Period.
Oh, me
so
too.
He's gonna be. He's just gonna have my emotional support.
I'm gonna go behind enemy territory. I'm gonna go into the heart of the beast.
Where
they kidnap people and like plead for my freedom.
But that's the one time I'm not on the other side of the camera, but I do enjoy, you know, being the filmer, because someone has to hold the camera. So, you know, I want to hear more of my stories from behind, you know, the scenes.
Yeah, you've been cop blocking with me a lot lately.
I've been cop blocking for a while, babe. I came into this cop
blocking.
I got
you into cop blocking. I introduced it.
That
was a date.
That was my first activism coming to Manchester, was cop blocking. That was a date, and, you know, I enjoyed it. I love holding signs, you know, warning people, and, you know, I love the whole cop block organization. I even love their logo. Like, that big face, just like,
Just the cop being recorded.
Yeah, just shining, just like a flashlight in it and a giant camera. Like, it's just perfect, and it's so big, and it's so out there, and people just immediately get it. I love cop blocks.
Because who likes actual cops?
Yeah, people hate cops. But anyway, so I'll be on the cop block panel at this year's convention is where I was going with that. So,
who's another panelist on this cop block panel that you're going to be on?
I'm just kidding. me and my fiance over here, my rebel lover, we'll be doing the cop block panel together. We have been cop blocking together. Cop block is a part of our relationship at this point.
Yeah, we kind of have to do it. Like, I remember back at Pork Fest, like, shit, there's tax collectors here. Like, we got to cop block the shit out of them, you know, or tax block. Would that be the proper terminology?
No, they're still like...
They're government agents. They're not cops, though. They're not cop blocking.
Oh, my God. Can I just backtrack here? So in this video, this cop goes, I'm not a kidnapper. I'm just an agent of the state. And, like, you just fast-forwarded this part of the video. Difference? I'm like, is this guy joking right now? Like, it's, like, almost as funny as bike cops. Because, like, it's like, you're an agent. Just think about the irony of, like, everything you're saying.
And also, if they love what they do, okay, if they think they're doing a just and moral and right thing, like, why do they get up mad when I ask them about kidnapping? Like, they should be proud that they're doing that. Like, they should be proud that that's what they do. They're paid to grab people and put them in a cage. Like, that's their job.
Yeah, your light bulb was endangering the welfare of a cop trying to really see your license plate unless he can actually get behind you and shine his head. Like, you weren't hurting anyone. He didn't even want to just tell you, you know, my light bulb. That's how you know that it was very, like, out to get you, because they didn't even care.
So, trying to look intimidated. They're, like, strutting, like, walking up to the car, like, you know, well, your light bulb's on. Like, we're gonna have to figure out what to do. Or, like, take care of this. Well, he said something along those lines.
Yeah, no,
like,
very official.
Deal with it. We gotta figure out how to deal with this situation.
Yeah,
here.
That's what he said. Like, literally, the light bulb being out, and it was just you knew it was very intentional, because he didn't say, "Hey, sir, did you know your light bulb's out?" Like, why the fuck would we just know that was out? Like, are we psychic?
Shit about a fucking light bulb.
Does something go off in the car? And we were like, "Sir, like, this is unreasonable. Like, how often do you check your car?"
You know,
apparently he has OCD, because he says once a day he walks around and inspects every single light of his car. So,
and he was proud of it too.
He was very proud. So I'm like, are we just like that lazy? Like, are we not like, are we the weirdos for not like obsessive compulsively checking our lights?
And he checks it every day on his cruiser.
Oh, every day.
Every day.
On his cruiser. He doesn't want to endanger people not being able to see his license plate.
I know.
What if a child needs that to survive?
I think I think I'm finding my niche as an activist. All right. I hate being a right to travel activist, but I found the niche in that. My niche is like finding like the most absurd, weird thing to be an activist for in the right to travel activism. Like, I'm not like driving without a license or without a license plate. Well, that actually did happen once. but that was when I first got here. That was like day number three by Manch. I'm now doing like these weird things. Like, there's a sticker that's not correct on the car. Now there's, you know, one light bulb over a government issued license plate, like right over the holder. Like, that's out. Like, just weird things that I'm finding to do. Like,
so
fight
to
the
be
court
a,
system with.
To be a right to travel activist, you have to not drive with a license.
Oh, no, there's a lot of different people that do right to travel activism. One being, which I agree with them on this, is, why do I need a some sort of identification issued to me by people I've never met to drive my car? You know, like, I don't need their permission to operate it or to go anywhere.
Yeah.
And the fact that they claim ownership over roads and whatnot, which they have a monopoly over. They own all the land. They don't allow competition in roads. There's no competition. There's no free market in road construction. It doesn't happen.
Yeah.
You know, so like they, because you're driving on their roads, even though it's supposed to be ours because we're the ones paying for it because they steal from us via taxation. You know, but who will build the road? That's how it goes down the whole who will build the roads segment. But no, I don't think I need, you know, don't get me wrong. You pick and choose your battles as a good activist.
Yeah.
I definitely have a piece of plastic in my wallet that somehow gives me magical powers to drive on their roads.
I don't have that piece of plastic, and I do it sometimes. Almost.
You're getting there.
You're getting there. Well, anyway, it's like it doesn't matter if you have a license, you're driving perfectly, as long as the light bulb for your license plate works, then you're fine. It just doesn't make sense how, you know, they blatantly bully you. So.
Oh yeah, it was such a huge intimidation factor. Like everything.
But they can't
doing.
Intimidate us. Like.
Yeah.
They really can't.
That's one thing. I see that. What are they gonna do? Kill me? Like. On camera, like with a bolt to the head, like they're not gonna do that.
Let's not jinx it, babe.
I know.
Not jinx it, but you never know what they're gonna do, and that's why the camera is your is that's
your
our weapon.
That's your only defense. Like if there's ever one thing you can ever learn from anything that you see from us doing or any
always
kind of
record the police.
Anytime it's just not the police. Anytime it's an agent of the state, if it's an agent of the state, you take out your smartphone, you hit record. And you upload it. You do that every single time.
Oh.
And have it ready. And know how to get to your phone camera fast to do it. Because sometimes you only have a few seconds.
Very true. And even to backtrack, you know, that wasn't happening when the tax collectors or whoever they were came to Hempfest to shut down stuff and check out to see if equipment was fireproof or some shit. Like, no one was recording them.
Yeah, no one was, like, cop blocking that stuff when that happened.
And, you know,
they
didn't
should have been.
They didn't even know about it. And I was like, what? Like... You should know about this. You should know about cop block. You should always be cop blocking. If you leave, you know, a muggle with one thing that I think everyone can understand and come together on, it should be cop blocking.
Andrew, well, at the festival, he had a great idea, like to do like activism, like set up like a cop block tent or table or something like that at all these different music festivals, because they're kind of on the same page, like, you know, fuck the police, I own my body, I get to choose what goes in it, so that you can relate cop block to that and educate a lot of people about, you know, resisting oppression by the police.
I mean, it's a philosophy you can understand, and cop block it also educates, which is great, because you got your resources there. It's not only saying fuck the police, it's saying fuck the police and here are your rights. Like, this is what you can say when the police try to pull you over. And I think that's why people think we're like so bold, or people say, you know, I can't be that brave. You know what? It's like, read your rights. You'll know where you stand. You know, like, you know what lines you have to cross and when they've crossed the line, because you're informed. And I think that's the best thing about cop block, is keeping people informed. And you have to be, especially when they can pull you over for like a light bulb being off over your license plate and like shoot you in the head. Yeah. That's a worry that you have to have.
Meanwhile, like there's a lot of other crime going on, but heaven forbid, like, I have a light bulb out.
Heaven forbid.
I don't know.
Well,
so babe, where can people find you on the interwebs?
I am the Rebel Mistress on Facebook, and you can also find me at seditioussirens.com, which is just our Facebook page. That's about it.
And then you can find this show at rebelloveshow.com. Go download us on iTunes and Stitcher. Peace.